Hi everyone, this is Anastasia from Strapi, and in this video, I will show you how to use components and dynamic zones. Components and dynamic zones are powerful capabilities that make Strapi stand out from other CMS options. It allows marketers to build new pages with dynamic layouts using configurable components. This way, they are not dependent on developers or designers for assistance because they can select components from the pre-arranged library. Developers benefit from this capability as well, since they spend less time and effort on content modeling. This feature shortens time to market and allows marketers to quickly and autonomously ship new pages that follow the brand guidelines, which are defined once the library is first built out. So what are dynamic zones and components? Well, components are ready-made groups of fields connected to a specific frontend. In Strapi, you can define your own custom component library with the help of designers and developers and create a website builder experience. You can make each content configurable. For instance, let marketers choose what color or shape the button should be, how to center text, etc. A dynamic zone is a building block that allows you to insert components to any page. You can add different component collections to any content type structure. Let's see how it works in practice. To add a dynamic zone or a component, we go to a content type builder and open any collection or a single type. Let's try to add a dynamic zone to a restaurant. We can see that this structure is ready and we already have one dynamic zone called blocks, which has a selection of different components that we can use. But let's try to add a new dynamic zone to the end of our page. We can give any name to this dynamic zone field. Let's call it restaurant information. Now we can add components to the dynamic zone. We can create a new one or use an existing component from a library that we have defined before. Here you can see that there are different collections of components. One is called blocks, for example, where we have the call to action, FAQ, etc. Other collection is called global for the footer navigation. Another one is called pricing, restaurant, shared, etc. So you can name it anything you want and organize it as you wish. Let's select a couple of components from the blocks collection. And there we go. We can see that there is a new dynamic zone with different components in it. Now let's try to add a new component to an existing page. Let's go to the Content Manager, choose any restaurant. This restaurant page has already been published, but let's say we want to add some more content to it, right in the middle of the page. Before doing that, let's have a look at what it looks like right now. This is the restaurant page. It has a couple of pictures, some information here, a couple of reviews, and that's it. So let's say we want to add a call to action block right here after the reviews. To add a new block, let's scroll to our dynamic zone. In here, we can see the button Add a Component to Blocks. That's the name of the dynamic zone that was here. Now we can see two different component collections. One is related to a restaurant and the other one is named Blocks, which means it's a general component collection, but we can name them anything we want. Let's find a call to action button. And we can see that there are different themes. Let's choose a primary theme. We can add a title. You can add some text that will be displayed below the title. And we can add our call to action. Once again, we can choose a theme of a button. Here, let's choose the secondary one and add a link. In target, we can choose if we want to open the page in a new tab or keep it in the same tab. And there we go. Once again, these components can be set in any way you wish. So if you wish to add more settings, for example, choose a font or choose a shape of a button, you can do that. Let's click on save and see what is our result. Here's our updated restaurant page. Let's scroll to the bottom and there we go, the new CTA block that we added just in a couple of minutes. The great thing about this feature is if I open another restaurant, I can see that there is no call to action in the bottom, but there is a different component with suggestions of other restaurants. It means that with dynamic zones and components, I can customize any page. Components and dynamic zones are great proofs of Strapi's customizability, flexibility, and adaptability to ever-changing environments. It helps all teams work independently, iterate faster, and have the right degree of control over the design. Thank you for watching this video. By the way, you can try Strapi out without having to install it. Just go to our website and fill out this form to get access to